Greetings, Saints. Prophetess Dawn O'Brien, servant of the Lord with Dawn's Heartfelt Corner here. I've got a word for you I want to share with you this afternoon. I'm calling it, you are coming out, my child. That was a word the Holy Spirit gave me this morning. I had a doctor appointment today, so I was up earlier, and the Holy Spirit was speaking to me, and I started giving me all this information. I started saying, Lord, I gotta go to a doctor appointment. So I had to get Daniel up. Daniel's been waking up earlier. So I really, truly believe God is getting ready to do something. Daniel's been getting up earlier. He had to help me prepare Dawn's breakfast, and we had to get that ready. And then I had to go to my doctor appointment. And everything went great, praise God, you know, because, I've been feeling like I have got a lot of strength and energy. You know, even my husband has said to me that you have, like, supernatural strength, is what he said, when he sees me in the gym. And it's always prayer, and I give glory to the Lord, because God is amazing. You know, he's just been giving me strength, and he gave me a poem, a message I read to you just the other day, do you feel humiliated and mocked at? And he also gave me that poem, when you feel all hope is gone. Are we online? I want to make sure we're online. Okay, we do have one person online here. So, but the Lord has been giving me, like, revelation. Because the last few times I've been writing these messages, he's been giving me such revelation. The Holy Spirit is awesome. And so, but today, to get back to what I was saying, I went to my doctor appointment this morning. I had to be there at 9:20. But when I came out, you know, my girlfriend laughed at me. She took me to my appointment, and I said, because she does cartridges, you know, and so she was dropping off some cartridges, then she comes back and get me, and so I said, the devil and its little angels, or whatever you want to call them, was over here today, because you know who came? The Jehovah Witnesses. Before they even could say anything, I knew they were not of the Lord, because they had those little, not that the watchtower, I think that's Jehovah's Witness. Well, he comes with these magazines, and I like stopped him in his track right before he even got started. He then he took off. And then after I met a lady, okay, now listen to this. I met this lady. She had back problems, and she said, because I was telling her about my car accident, and she said she had back problems, and she was, she had colon cancer. So I asked her, I said, could I pray with you? And she immediately said, well, I got to go. I got to do an errand for my son. You know, that's what's happening. People could be on their deathbed, and it's like they don't care. They don't care about getting prayer for, they got a problem or something. Because Daniel and I used to see people when I lived over in my old apartment. I'd be up at the Walmart, and I would see people in this wheelchair smoking their cigarette, and wheeling around in this wheelchair on the phone, and I remember wanting to pray with them, and they're like, no, that's okay, I'm busy, you know. So but some people, they want to stay sick, you know, because we've met people that say that way they can keep getting money and help. But I'm telling you right now, Saints, there is coming a day when money is going out the door, and no one's going to be able to help us. Okay, only Jesus is going to help us, and we're going to have to look to Jesus. We're not going to look to a man. I'll tell you right now, man's not going to help us. All right. But I wanted to tell you what happened. All right. So let's pray, and then we're going to worship a little. I wasn't going to. I was a little tired today. I'm sorry, Saints. I'm tired. But you know what? God gives me grace and strength to keep going. So let's pray. The songs that we're going to worship is like a mixture of songs. And we're just going to worship God, and then I'm going to bring the word to you. Okay? So let's just pray this morning. This afternoon. I'm losing track of the topics this afternoon. So, Father, we thank you for this day, Lord. We just love you and praise you, Lord. Thank you for giving us your grace and strength, Lord. We can do all things through Christ who strengthens us. Lord, I ask you to just be on this video and have me speak what you would have me say. Precious Holy Spirit, you are welcome here. We give you the honor, the praise, and glory, Lord, that your word shall go forth, touching hearts and touching lives, Lord. And Lord, we pray that there will be many souls on here that will hear the word of the Lord and give their hearts and lives to you, because it's all about you, Lord. We give you the praise. We give you the honor. We give you the glory in Jesus' name. Amen, amen. Now I'm going to ask him, I don't know if there's anybody on here that's on Facebook. My husband is looking because he's subscribed through our judgment website. I'm trying to find out if they're all connected together because we're trying to do that. My husband tried to put the app on there so that the people on Facebook can hear. You know, if you're not on the YouTube website and you're not receiving notifications, I know there's a section, I believe, I don't know if it's a right or left, you click onto it to receive notifications, and then you can receive those notifications when I'm doing a live video, because I never know when I'm going to start coming on here live. I come on whenever the Holy Spirit has me come on, whenever I have the time. Okay, so I wanted to let you know that. Let's worship Jesus for a little bit here. Then I'm going to bring you a few encouraging words here. But I'm going to play this one. I've played it before. Mandisa, Overcomers. Overcomer. You and I are overcomers. We're getting ready to go to war. I'm telling you, saints. All right. Let's pray.
Watching people drive by, T-Mac on the radio. Got so much on your mind, nothing's really going right. Looking for a ray of hope. Whatever it is you may be going through,
or the conquer thing. You and I to quit and give up. No, we're not quitting. We're going to keep going. Praise God. Days of Elijah by Paul Wilbur. praise God. Let's praise Him. Say,
praise Him. Give Him praise. God is worthy. Lord, we love You. Hallelujah. We love You, Lord. You are worthy. We exalt You, Lord. We lift Your name upon us. He's all the end, Lord. You are worthy of our praise. You're worthy of our glory. Hallelujah. 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 Praise Him. Let's praise Him.
These are the days of Elijah, declaring the word of the Lord. And these are the days of your servant Moses, righteousness being restored. And though these are days of great trials, of famine and darkness and sore, still we are the voice in the desert, crying, prepare ye the way of the Lord. The only house, riding on the clouds, shining like the sun, as the trumpet calls, lift your voice, and hear unto the King, out of Zion's hills salvation comes. Holy, 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 holy. The dry bones becoming as flesh. And these are the days of your servant David, rebuilding a temple of praise. And these are the days of the harvest, the fields are winding the world. And we are your laborers in your linger, declaring the word of the Lord. In holy house, riding on the clouds, shining like the sun, at the trumpet call, lift your voice, in the year of Jubilee, out of Zion's hills, salvation comes. In holy house, riding on the clouds, salvation comes.
Every Chain by Jesus Culture. We're going to sing that one. God's going to break the chains of the enemy. Get ready. Get ready. It's coming. Thank you, Lord, for what you're about to do, Lord. We praise you. We praise you, Lord. Hallelujah.
Power in the name of Jesus.
Sing it, thank you.
There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. Break every chain, break every chain, break every chain. There's power. There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. To break every chain, to break every chain, to break every chain.
Friend of God. I was going to play this one the other day, and I forgot. So we're going to play Friend of God.
You're a friend of God. We are friends of God. Isn't that awesome?
Do you believe that tonight? Every day with you, Lord. Oh, yes.
It's hot.
James 2:23 says Abraham believed. How many believers here tonight?
Amen.
And it says it was accounted to him for righteousness. And he was called the friend of God.
A friend of God.
I thank God that he calls us his friends. In spite of all that we have done, if we'll only believe, say only believe, only believe, only believe. Who am I that you are mindful of me? That you hear me when I
call.
Is it true that you are thinking of me? How you love me? It's amazing. Who am I? Who am I that you are mindful of me? Thinking of me, how you love me. Well, Lord, it's amazing.
Alrighty, I love the worship of Jesus, don't you? We're singing one more. Be strong and take courage. Let's be strong, saints. We're getting ready to go through more trials. We're gonna go through more. Be strong.
And take courage. Do not fear or be dismayed. For the Lord will go before you, and his light will show the way. Be strong and take
strong.
Hey, let's have some, before I get into the encouraging words for you today, I want to give you a little bit of news here. I just put it up today, but Paul Bagley did this yesterday. Earth clung through Halley's Comet debris field of meteors and fireballs, he says. Halley's Comet has left a huge debris field of meteors and fireballs that the Earth is now passing through. And I put up a video by BP Earth Watch, so go take a look at it. And also, he did another one, multiple large meteors striking our atmosphere now. This was done, I believe, yesterday. And then Paul Bagley did one, breaking 2 megaquakes and 100 aftershocks rock Alaska. Remember, we've talked about this. Alaska's been having so many earthquakes. You know, God was showing me something yesterday. I'm just going to read you what he was showing me. What God was showing me when I was listening to Dutch Sins, which I've given you the link before, so you can go on there and listen to him. He talks about all the earthquakes. He knows a lot about it. He's really good. And I said, Alaska keeps getting hit hard, and we are seeing more in California. He's talking about it more. So it's happening slow in California, but I'm telling you, Saint, it's going to happen. People think it's not coming. It is coming. Chile, Canada, and the Philippines. Volcanoes in Hawaii. We're seeing volcanoes that are waking up everywhere. Something my spirit was telling me, they're going to increase on the coast. That's what he was showing me. Along the coast, they're going to increase. Now, is that the Ring of Fire now? He talks about the slow. Okay, I said soap. It's slow. Go take a listen to that video. If you have Dutch Sense, I don't have it on right on here, but I have put it on other past videos. Let's also take a look at what's happening on the live earthquake map. I've given that to you as well. Let's see what's going on here. I like to keep tabs on it daily and see what's happening, because I mean, things can change at any moment. Okay, California is still getting 1.4, 1.3. Okay, they're getting 0.9, 0.4. They may be getting smaller, but they are going to increase. All right, Alaska is still getting them 1.8, 1.8, 1.1 in California. Canada had a 2.6, Washington had 2.0 50 minutes ago, and I think they had another one. They did great. I thought it was higher than that. California, Alaska had a 2.0 51 minutes ago. 1.5 in Washington 52 minutes ago. California 1.6, 2.0 in Alaska. 3.3 in Washington. That was up higher, I believe. That was over an hour ago. 3.3. And a 2.4 in Alaska. Montana had a 1.7. Hawaii had a 1.8. That was 88 minutes ago. Alaska is still getting them. 2s and 2.8s. And California is still small. 0.8, 0.3, 0.6, 1.2. 5.3 in the South Sandwich Islands 2 hours ago. See, and here, California's getting a bunch of them now. They're small. They're in the 1s and points. But they've had 2s and 3s and even 4s. Alaska had a 2.0 4 hours ago, 2.6 in California 4 hours ago, and a 3.4. So I believe, I'm telling you right now, something is going to come and it's going to happen. Boom, like that. Okay? And people are ignoring the signs. They're not listening. All right? We also see 2.3 in Alaska 5 hours ago, 2.4 and 2.4 5 hours ago. 2.2 in Hawaii 6 hours ago. Canada 2.3 6 hours ago, and 2.1 in Alaska. There was a 2.6 in Alaska 7 hours ago. Canada had another one 2.9. Peru had one at 5.1 7 hours ago. And Hawaii 2.7 and 2.4 in Alaska. There has been a lot in Alaska. So that is what is happening, Saints, with the earthquake map. So I've given you that link. I don't know if I put it right on this one or not. So you can go and take a look at it. And that right now, I don't think there's anybody watching online. If there's anybody here, which I don't think, but I do believe we are online. So we're just going to keep going with it. All right, I've got some encouraging words I'm going to read to you before we talk about what I want to talk about. This is from that little journal, Grace, for today. Together with God, I can do everything through Him who gives me strength. That's Philippians 4:13.
The Holy Spirit of God, who fills God's entire creation, can also live in your heart. Accepting this truth releases the power of God in your life. When you think of yourself as a part of God's revelation of himself, you enter into an intimacy with him that will bring strength, balance, and vitality to your life. When you realize that God created you and that you're governed by his Spirit, you can also realize that your life should live up to his expectations. You no longer live to please yourself, but rather to do his will. See, it's not about what we want to do. It's about what God wants to do. We're living to please God's will. Through the grace of God and his Spirit, you can live a life pleasing him through the strength of the Lord Jesus Christ. Here's a prayer. Merciful Lord Jesus, I accept the gift of the Holy Spirit, and therefore I can enjoy intimate fellowship with you, my Lord and my God. Amen. Now, I'm going to read this. I almost forgot. While we're singing that song about I'm a friend of God, God calls you and I friends, and he gave me a scripture. I want to read this to you. All right, if you've got a Bible, you might want to get it, because we're going to read some scriptures, okay? But this is in John. My nose keeps itching, sorry. John 15, starting verse 13. Greater love has no one than this, that he laid down his life for his friends. Verse 14, you are my friends if you do what I command. You notice how he said that. You're his friends if you obey the Lord. If you do what God commands you to do, then he calls you friends. Okay? He's not calling everybody his friend. Hey, I just stopped there. You know, I just noticed that. Greater love is no one than this, that he laid down his life for his friends. You are my friends if you do what I command. See, if you're not obeying the Lord, you're not his friend. That's good. I like that. Now remain in my love. Oh, wrong verse here. You are my friends if you do what I command. Verse 15, I no longer call you servants because a servant does not know his master's business. So if you're spending time with God, you're going to know what God wants. You know, I wrote something down. I said I wanted to do a sermon on it because you can't know God's will unless you are spending time with God. And see, that's when God says he calls you friends. You're no longer servants, because the servant does not know the master's business. You know, and there's a lot of people that don't see what's going on, okay? But when you're close to the Lord, the Holy Spirit is going to show you, and you're going to see it, okay? Let's get back to this. Instead, I have called you friends, he says. We're reading verse 15. For everything that I learned from my Father, I've made known to you. See, God's making things known to you and to me. If you are obeying the Lord, he's calling you friends. And then verse 16, he said, you did not choose me, but I chose you. See, God chose you. He appointed you to go and bear fruit that will last. Then the Father will give you whatever you ask in my name. This is my command. Love each other. Verse 17. You can read that starting John 15. Starting in verse 15, I read through 17, which you can read through 16. I just want to share that with you because that was a scripture God gave to me while we were worshiping. You know, he does that sometimes, and, you know, I don't know where everything's at. They got the gateway, you know, I can look things up. I have a concordance. I probably should pull out and start using it. Let me read you Marsha Burns. I thought this was a good word. She says, I speak to those who are silently but profoundly disappointed, she says. Do not forget that I am for you, and I want you to come through in victory. See, God wants you and I to come in victory. God is for you. He's not against you. That is my will, she says. Going through difficult times provides an opportunity to learn an important truth that is necessary to your spiritual growth. Pray fervently, she says. Talk to me, says the Lord, and trust that I answer. See, just like, I want to stop right there. You know, I told Daniel this the other day. You know, I don't go to anybody else. I go to God. You know, even when, you know, I had to go to the doctor, yes, I go and do what I'm supposed to do. But if something was major, I go to Dr. Jesus. I'm going to tell you right now, I don't go to a man like Daniel's worrying because our rent is coming up. Pray for us. I'm not worried. I trust the Lord. He knows exactly what he's doing. Okay, we've got to sign the lease and renew it. They're going to let us know, I think, in June or July. And he's foreboding, worrying about it ahead of time. In August, we've got to decide what we're doing. I tell Daniel, calm down. Because when he gets stressed out, then he makes me stressed. So I'm like, I trust the Lord. You know, we were thrown out on the street. I know God will take care of us. He's not going to put us back out there. Okay, so I trust the Lord fully. I don't look to a man because it's going to get to a point where we can't go to a man. I mean, if things happen and people lose their jobs and the economy goes, what are you going to do? You know, Daniel gets frustrated because he can't work and he said, supporting me, he said. He gets upset. Daniel really wants to work and he can't work. But I know God's healing because now he's been getting up early in the morning. You know, so there's a reason for this whole thing. I don't understand it. I trust the Lord. You know, and so that's why I said people have talked about us, judged us, made us feel like you know, like, what was that word I gave? I just talked about it. Humiliated, mocked at us. They've done that. You know what? But praise God. You know, God knows. You know, so I try to calm Daniel down, you know, because he gets upset, you know, and he gets all stressed out. And so I got to calm him down. I gotta calm him down. I gotta calm down to them because she'll start crying. Praise the Lord, you know. So we got a lot going on in this house at times, but you know what? God's awesome. God is what helps all of us to keep going. We have to keep our focus on Jesus. I'm telling you, saints, we can't get our focus on the problems or things that are happening. We gotta keep our eyes on Jesus because everything in this world will pull you and I down. So we've gotta constantly stay fixed on Jesus. We've got to worship Jesus. We've got to read the Bible. Make sure you're studying the Word of God. It's so important, saints. All right, let me read you this little scripture she has. James 5:16. Confess your trespasses to one another and pray for one another that you may be healed. The effective fervent prayer of a righteous man avails much. Prophet Russ said this. The Father says today, learn to pray deep prayers. Discipline yourself to make the time and take the time to shut the world out and its distractions. And truly seek my face. There is a reward, says the Father, for those who come to me in the press. It has come in vogue to criticize the reality of the deeps of my spirit by those who have no appetite for greater realities in me. Reject all such thinking. Abandon all those who sit in the seat of scornful. Avoid the counsels of those who walk in the way of error, refusing to question the positions of unbelief and mockery of my word. I call you this day to return to the simplicity of spirit that accompanies all those who have approached my throne in truth and come away with the answer to their need. Learn to pray big prayers, says the Father. See, stop praying small prayers, pray big prayers. He says, as I said in my word, according to your faith, so be it unto you. Faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word. Your capacity for big answers is directly measured by the depth of your anchor in my word and the dimensions of expectation by which you ask me daily for the impossible. So we've got to believe the impossible. No, it's not here yet, but that doesn't mean it's not coming. We have got to believe. What I'm telling you, my son and daughter, is you aren't thinking big enough. The self-referred teacher believes that big things for themselves are only found in belittling others. Uh-huh. Do you know that? I do. People try to put me down. We're going to talk about that in just a minute. All right. Because of this, they teach lots of things, but you come away diminished. It isn't something you have done wrong. You are simply feeding the wrong trough. Come up higher. Embrace the truth that breathes the enlargement of who I am in your life. Then water walking conquest will come as easy as getting out of bed in the morning. Then everything you say and do will begin to be as effective as I said it or did it. This is your portion. Now is the moment I call you to step under my promise in your life. Praise the Lord. Now I'm going to share this little thing with you. I think it's funny. You know, for those, I don't know if you're on our Facebook or not. Prophet Russ is. Now I don't know if Prophet Russ is listening. But I think it's funny because, you know, I think he wrote me maybe once or so. Well, you know, I get people persecuting me on YouTube and on Facebook. And I'm going to tell you right now, I am going through things. Daniel and I are both going through trials right now. Okay? And I may not look or dress or act the way you want me to. And people say things. And so my Italian temper gets fiery and gets upset, you know. So I wrote this letter and stuck it up on Facebook, you know, and Papa Russ coming. And I said to Daniel, I said, Daniel, Papa Russ coming. I said, he never does. And, you know, Daniel says to me, I had a chuckle and laugh. He goes, you better listen to the prophet. I thought that was so funny. But he was nice and sweet. We love you, Papa Russ. We love you and Kitty. We appreciate you. All right. Praise God. God is good. All right. I think that's it. I gave those two words. All right. Let's talk about what God was giving me. You know, I got another word I'm going to share with you. If we got time, praise the Lord. Not today, though, saints. I'm not going to share it today. I'm going to maybe try, unless God gives me something else to say, I may share it on Friday. It's actually it's a word, but it's a teaching, too. You know, I've noticed that God gives me these prophetic words, but they're teachings. I see going into a teaching. And he was telling me, your heart belongs to me. I heard him say that. And so, but I'm going to share that Lord's will Friday, maybe Friday or Saturday. All right. But I heard him say this to me, and as I was getting ready to go to the doctor, I was like, Lord, you're giving me this now, and I don't have much time. But this is what he gave me, and then I just wrote a poem about a couple hours ago, because he gave me a title of it, and I didn't have a poem, and I said, well, I'm going to write a poem. You know, and if you heard the other poem, I'm going to try to read it maybe another time. I'll read it again, but I just read a poem that God gave me, When You Feel All Hope Is Gone, that I wrote. And that was a prophetic poem. And I've noticed God's been giving me prophetic poems. You know, David was a writer. And I said, God, you are so awesome. God is awesome. So I want to share this word. He said this to me. You are coming out, my child. That's what I heard him say. And this word is not just for me. I know it's for others. There are others that have been waiting and waiting and waiting. And you have been seeking the Lord. And I'm telling you, saints, we are almost there. I'm not kidding. We're on the brink. God is about to move. Now, I'm not sure exactly how he's going to move. But it's not for you and I to figure it out. We're to trust the Lord, okay? So I'm going to share this word. You are coming out, my child. If you've got a Bible, you might want to read some scriptures with me, or you got a pen and paper and write them down, because I may not read all the scripture. Remember, you've got to study. It's so important, saints, so that you know what the Bible says. You can't listen to everybody that's preaching, because I'm telling you a lot right now, they're preaching out of their own mindsets. They're not even using the Word of God. We, the church, are getting away from the Word. And that is very, very dangerous. I mean, God was showing me something yesterday. You know, it's... let me think of how I want to say it. But, you know, he was showing me that, you know, how we become, well, not yet complacent. But, you know, when we get to the point where things don't bother us anymore. When God convicts us, and if you and I don't repent right away, it'll get to a point where we think it's okay. We can just sin and do whatever. And that's dangerous, saints. Because later on, I'll read you a scripture. It talks about 7 demons entering you. And you backslid. And it's harder for you to come back to God. That is very, very dangerous. So I said, Lord, I never want that. I want to repent right away. I want God to deal with me. Don't you? Don't you want God to deal with you? All right. But he gave me this word today at 6:43 a.m. This is what I heard him say. The enemy thinks he has trapped you, but he can think again. Do you feel like that? I know I have been lately. He thinks he has trapped you. You are coming out, says the Lord. I heard him say that. You are coming out. Victory is yours. That's right. Victory is yours, praise the Lord. Have you been lied to? Stop listening to his lies, says the Lord. Is he whispering in your ear? Turn it off. Don't listen to his lies. Maybe it's a husband, a wife, somebody living in your house. You better turn it off. You better not listen to it. You better shut it out. All right? You've got to listen to what the Holy Spirit is saying. You know, and yes, it may not happen right this minute. And it may not be here. But that doesn't mean it's not coming. If God told you something, okay, and you know that you know that you know, you stand up. Remember, I've given it. Habakkuk 2:2-3. Though the vision tarry, wait for it. It'll surely come. God has a set timing. No, we don't know God's timing, but we have to be patient and we have to wait. He's got to put all the pieces together. So we have to wait. All right. He said, God will not give you more than you can handle.
you can handle this. You can handle it. Don't say you can't handle it. There are those right now, duck-a-doo, that are saying, I can't handle it. Oh, yes, you can. You can handle whatever God is throwing at you. You know, in one of my books, I said, no, I never had children. There are those that had children. All right, you can bear children. You can handle this. Whatever you're getting right, whatever you're going through or you're getting ready to go through, you can handle it. You want to know why? Because Jesus, he lives in you. Without him, no, you can't handle it. Apart from Christ, you can do nothing. But with Christ, you can do all things. He is your strength. He is my strength. If we will get our eyes on King Jesus, we can overcome. That overcoming power lives in you. And I think I just said that. No, not yet. All right. I said you can handle this. Why? Because I, King Jesus, am right there with you through this storm. See, God's right there. He didn't leave you. Maybe you think that God's left you. Don't listen to the enemy's lies. He's lying to you. I know he does that to my husband. He thinks God's not there. No, no. That's not true. God may stand back, but yes, God is there. He wants to see, what are you going to do? Are you going to trust the Lord, or are you going to make a move and do something yourself? You better trust the Lord. You better wait on the Lord until God tells you to move. And when he says move, then you move. Okay? Now, now, if your heart is right and you're wanting to do it right and you feel that God's telling you to go, then step out. He'll show you if that's the wrong move. Okay? But if God has not told you to do something, don't just do it just to do it. Because you don't want to wait. And I'm going to tell you right now, there's a lot of people that don't want to wait. No one likes to wait. You think I like to wait? No. All right? We live in a microwave generation. We got to have it right now, right this minute. So when we eat, what do? We stick in the microwave. So we're hungry. We're going to eat it right now. We don't want to wait. People don't want to sit in church now. They have drive-through churches. We don't want to wait. Well, I told you that before. I believe we're going to have to wait. All right? And I don't know how long. We're going to have to wait for the return of Christ. I'm telling you, saying, I know there are those saying, oh, we're going to fly out of here. We're going home. Goodbye. They're doing their last video on YouTube. Now, I don't believe that, okay? The one girl that was doing all these videos, the rapture puzzles, she had it all figured out. Well, I'll tell you right now, God's not going to do things your way, my way. He's going to do things his way. He is God Almighty, all right? And he is not going to tell you when he is coming. He said, no man will know the day or the hour, okay? So you and I do not know, but we have to be ready. We have to make sure our lamps are burning. We've got to stay hot on fire for Christ. We can't become lukewarm. The church cannot become lukewarm. You can read in Revelation about the lukewarm churches. God wants you and I on fire. Father, I pray that right now. Set your people on fire. Set them on fire, Lord. Set us on fire for you, Lord. We need you, Jesus. We need you. Set our hearts on fire in Jesus' name. See, that's what's going to happen. People are going to go where their itchy ears want to go. They don't want to hear truth. They want to hear things that, oh, comfort their flesh. No, no. We have to follow God. We have to be willing to put our foot in and do what God's saying to do, even if we don't feel like doing it. I'm going to tell you right now, God makes Daniel and I do things we don't want to do. All right? So you're going to have to do them too. I'm sorry. I know people don't want to hear it, but that's the truth. I'm not going to come on here. I'm not going to lie to you and tell you some false gospel. All right? There's enough of that going on around there. And you know what? They're making all this money. They're preaching false doctrine. Well, I'm going to tell you right now, that's all about to change. Because people are hurting now, and they're going to be hurting even more in the future. And they want something that is going to minister to their spirit. They're tired of hearing false doctrine. I don't know about you, but I'm tired of it. I don't want to hear another false message. All right. Let's get back to this. I said, you can handle this. Why? Because King Jesus, I'm right there with you through the storm. You shall not fail or falter, says the Lord. You're not going to fall. You're not going to falter. Don't give up or retaliate. That's right. Don't give up. Don't retaliate. Don't go back. And then he said this. The meaning of the word, let me first tell you, the word falter means start to lose strength or momentum. Okay? The word falter, start to lose strength or momentum. Where are you going to go? That's what I heard him say. Where are you going to go? There is no place for you to go, my child. You're either going to follow me or not. See, there's nowhere we can go. You're either going to follow Christ or you're not going to follow him.
Decide today, are you going to follow the Lord or you're not? Okay? I'm not going to twist your arm. I'm not going to, I know there are atheists that come on here. There are people that don't even believe in Christ, okay? I'm not here to conform you, to make you believe. I'm here to plant a seed, all right? And somebody else may water it. If you don't believe in Christ, oh well. That's not my job. My job is to preach the gospel, to preach the truth. Because if I don't, I'm going to answer. We are all going to stand before the Lord and give an account for what we've done in this body of ours, whether it was good or bad. So if you've got people around you, you better preach the gospel. You better tell them about Christ. You better tell them these are the last days. Because what's going to happen if you don't tell them when we stand before the Lord and these people are going to say, hey, how come nobody told me? You know, they can't say that about me because Prophet Dawn O'Brien is telling you. Prophetess Dawn O'Brien is telling you, don't turn this station off because you don't want to hear it, okay? I'm telling you the truth. Now, you can either believe it or not believe it. I mean, I'm not judging you, and that's what I always say. I'm not judging no one, but I'm going to be accountable to God if I don't tell you. You know, I've got enough to answer for. We all do. Thank God for the blood of Christ. Our sins are under the blood. As far as the east is from the west, God has forgiven us. Isn't that awesome? God's mercy and grace is new every day. What an awesome God we serve. We serve an awesome God. Praise the Lord. All right, I want to read you the scripture. It's a long one. All right, I'm going to read it to you. I've read it before. Saints, I don't get tired of telling you the same things over and over again. It's for your learning. We need to hear it. The church needs to hear it. They don't want to hear it, but the truth is what's going to set us free, all right? Dancing around, drinking our mochas, and clapping around, that's not going to do anything. That's not going to defeat the enemy, all right? The power of God is in our mouth. When we speak God's word, we know God's word. We've got to speak his word. We've got to read the word of God. We've got to stop acting like babies and drinking milk. Let's eat the word of God, the meat of God's word, all right? I'm sorry. I'm bold, I'm strong, I'm going to preach it loud and clear. I don't care if nobody likes it, okay? I'm not here to be a man pleaser, I'm here to be a God pleaser. And that's what you need to do. We're here to be God pleasers, because I'm going to tell you right now, we're seeing our world changing. Are we going to try to fit in with the world? Are we going to come out? Jesus said we're to come out and be separate. Touch an unclean thing and I'll receive you. We're not to be like the world, we're to be like Jesus. We're to be like Jesus. No, we're not perfect. I'm not perfect. I'm far from it. Lord, we need you to make us more like you. Wash us and cleanse us and change us, oh God. You're changing us from glory to glory. It's only by your power, Lord, that we can change as we submit ourselves to you and allow you to change us, Lord. So do the work in us, I pray today in Jesus' name. Amen. We have to be willing. We have to be willing to submit to God. And let God change us. You know, God's not going to change you if you're not willing to submit and do things his way. All right? If you want to do things your way and you want to fight against the Lord, no, he's not going to bother you. He's going to stick you up on a shelf with the dust gloves. He's not going to bother you. Okay? But if you're willing, you submit to God and say, yes, Lord, I want your will. He's going to do it. He's going to do it. Yes, it's going to hurt. I'm not going to lie to you and tell you it won't hurt. Oh, yes, it'll hurt. It's going to take you everything that you got. You know, because when you give your life to the Lord, you're taking up your cross and following Christ. You're dying to your flesh, yourself, and what you want. Your desire. Oh, I think I just broke it down. I did. Praise God. But you know what? Praise the Lord. I get on fire for the Lord. I don't care. I'm on fire for God. You know, I get excited. I love the Lord. You know, the Holy Spirit is here saying, the Holy Spirit is here. And you know, this message may not be for everyone, but that's okay. God is talking to certain people. I know the Holy Spirit is. The Holy Spirit is reaching people. And there are those that maybe that are going to come to Christ that have not given their hearts and lives to him yet, that God is trying to reach. All right. Let's get back here. John 6, 60 through 71. We're going to talk about that. I've read it before. You can turn to it if you've got a Bible. John 6, 60 through 71. Many disciples turn away. Verse 60. Therefore, many of his disciples, when they heard this, said, this is a hard saying. Who can understand it? Verse 61. When Jesus knew in himself that his disciples complained about this, he said to them, does this offend you? Verse 62, what then if you should see the Son of Man ascend where he was before? Verse 63, it is the Spirit who gives life. The flesh profits nothing. See, you hear that? Let me read it again. 63, it is the Spirit who gives life. The flesh profits nothing. The words that I speak to you are spirit and they are life. Verse 64, but there are some of you who do not believe. For Jesus knew from the beginning who they were who did not believe and who would betray him. Verse 65, and he said, therefore I have said to you that no one can come to me unless it has been granted to him by my Father. So you can't come to Christ unless God the Father calls you. You cannot come. Verse 66, from that time, many of his disciples went back and walked with him no more. Verse 67, then Jesus said to the 12, do you also want to go away? And listen to this by Simon Peter, verse 68. But Simon Peter answered, Lord, to whom shall we go? You have the words of eternal life. Verse 69, also we have come to believe and know that you are the Christ, the Son of the living God. Verse 70, Jesus answered him, did I not choose you? See, God has chosen you. Isn't that awesome? Out of everybody, God chose you. He chose me, praise the Lord. The 12, he says, did I not choose you, the 12? And one is the devil. See, he knew who was the devil. Verse 71, he spoke of Judas Iscariot, the son of Simon, for it was he who would betray him, being one of the 12. All right, then God said to me, you are an overcomer. That's right, we're overcomers, saying, just like that song we sang. You're an overcomer. I love that. We're overcoming by the blood of the Lamb and the words of our testimony. We are overcomers. You're overcoming faith residing in the inside of you. It is time now to use it. Now, I got to give you this revelation God was showing me. I'm not going to read all this, but he was showing me this, which we've known this. You know, God talks about faith and what it is because, you know, he was showing me. That time is now. We're getting ready to apply what we've read, okay? I know we're going to talk about it in a minute. Let me finish reading this here. What is faith? You've read it several times in Scripture. Put my words into action, I heard him say. The Bible is not just a written storybook. And see, that's what people think. They think the Bible is some written storybook. That was just something long ago. No, I'm telling you right now, it's for now. God is getting ready to do something now, so we've got to put it into action. It is real. The Holy Spirit inspired the disciples to write it for our learning, and that's so true. God had the disciples write. The Holy Spirit had them inspired. They wrote the Bible, all right? And it wasn't for us just to skip over scriptures and ignore it. No, we're to read it. God wants you to start reading the Word of God. Read the whole chapter of faith in your spare time. I'm not going to read it. Hebrews 11, 1 through 6. You can read it. We've talked about it before, okay? You can read the whole chapter. I'm going to read you in a minute, Hebrews 11, 1 through 6. But you can read the whole chapter of Hebrews 11. All right? God said this to me. Read the whole chapter of faith in your spare time. Study God's word so you know what it says. My people die for lack of knowledge. The Bible says in Hosea 4, we've talked about that. My people die for lack of knowledge. That's because we don't know what God's word is saying. We don't read the word of God. Are you reading the word of God? All right? If you can find time to watch TV, go on Facebook. All right? Hey, we all have done that. We can find time to watch TV, go on Facebook, play computer games, or any other hobbies that you might do. Maybe, I don't know, I work out. I got to be careful. I don't work out a lot. I put Jesus first. You can make time for God. There is no excuse, okay? There is no excuse. You can take some time out of your day to make time for God. Get up a little earlier, pray, and start seeking God. Put God first in your life. And when you put God first in your life, you want to know something? He'll put you first. He'll do things for you. When you start putting God first, don't put them at the bottom of your list. Don't say, I'm going to pray later, and then you go to sleep and you forget to pray, or you're too tired to pray. Put God first in your life. Start making God number one. Hebrews 11, 1 through 6 says, by faith we understand Now, faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. For by it the elders obtain a good testimony. Verse 2. Verse 3 says, by faith we understand that the worlds were framed by the word of God, so that the things which are seen were not made of things which are visible. See, we got to walk by faith, not sight. We got to walk by faith. Verse 4. By faith, Abel offered to God a more excellent sacrifice than Cain, through which he obtained witness that he was righteous, God testifying of his gifts, and through it, he being dead still speaks. Verse 5. By faith, Enoch was taken away so that he did not see death, and was not found because God had taken him. For before he was taken, he had this testimony that he pleased God. But without faith, it's impossible to please him. For he who comes to God must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of those who diligently seek him. I like that. Let me read that again. Verse 6. But without faith, it's impossible to please him. So we can't please God without faith. We've got to have faith. Then it says, for he who comes to God must believe that he is. See, in order to come to Christ, you have to believe that who he is. And that he is a rewarder. He's going to reward those who diligently seek him. So if you're spending time seeking God and you're putting God first, God's going to bless you. God's got a reward in mind for you. But you got to put God first. All right. I heard him say, you're much stronger than you think. See, you're much stronger. Don't say you can't handle this. You're not stronger. Oh, yes, you are. You can handle what's coming. Hold your head up in all circumstances and fight the good fight of faith, says the Lord. God wants you to fight the good fight of faith. 1 Timothy 6:12 through 14. Fight the good fight of faith. Lay hold on eternal life to which you were also called and have confessed a good confession in the presence of many witnesses. Verse 13, I urge you in the sight of God who gives life to all things, and before Christ Jesus who witnessed the good confession before Pontius Pilate. Verse 14, that you keep this commandment without spot, blameless until our Lord Jesus Christ appearing. God has a victory crown in store for you, for all those that finish the race.